Hey Jude, don't make it bad. Take a sad song and make it better. Remember to let her into your heart. Then you can start to make it better.
Hi, this is Claudia Lopez with GNO. Miami is the home and the host of Art Basel, and I am here tonight at Adrian Arch Center. I am so excited that Julian Lennon is here tonight. He's about to introduce his pieces, Timeless. My producer got a hold of every single one of those hosts from GNO. I was the first one to reply, and I'm excited that I'm going to be able to speak with him about his art, his music, and his future projects. Hi, we're inside the Adrian Arch Center with Julian Lennon. How are you tonight?
Toasty. I'm good. I'm all good.
Me too. We have Timeless here. Why the name? Why that title?
I think it's because most of the sort of painterly work that I do, the landscapes, aren't tied into any particular time or a place. I think there are images that are timeless and zen-like and dreamlike and have a certain element of peace to them. And that's basically why, to be honest with you. It's sweet and simple. Short, sweet and simple.
So why do you take pictures of nature? Are you in touch with your with the earth type side?
Well, I mean, I've always been, environmental and humanitarianly orientated, you know, I think it's in all of our best interests to be that way and to care about Mother Earth and our surroundings. You know, if we don't, we're not going to live very long, are we? So, you know, I just see a lot of beauty around us, and I like to try and capture that in the best way possible. You know, very subtle, but yes, you know, that's of course I love it.
So I'm almost positive that you recycle, right?
Of course I do. Absolutely.
Me too. Of course. Of course. They're beautiful. I also see the pictures of the artists. You capture a sense of, it's beauty. I mean, it's not opposing. It's just in the moment. Is that your style?
I think that's one, you know, I don't think... One should, as a creative person, be pigeonholed in any way, shape, or form. You know, the black and whites of U2 and some of Sean, my brother, and a few others, it's just another side. It's something I love to do as much as the painterly work. It's just another style within the photography, you know.
So you prefer black and white when you're taking pictures of artists?
Well, I mean, they're not completely black and white. They're sort of desaturated. But, you know, there's a little bit of elements of color in there, but very, very subtle. But I think that adds a little, for me, a lot more depth to a photograph, a little more history, a little more emotion. For me, that's... originally the colors were, the pictures were color, but you know that my choice was to draw that out and have the raw emotions left, so to speak.
Which brings me up: what do you think of the whole Photoshop? I mean, I see that you like everything as is.
I mean, there are some elements that you do use within Photoshop. Because sometimes digital pictures can be dirty, and you do need to clean them, or you want to. Edit them a little differently, cut them a little differently. I don't necessarily agree, of course, with photoshopping when it's taken to such a degree that the person doesn't even look like themselves anymore. You know, I think that's very scary. I think it's very misleading especially for young teenagers and teenage girls, especially when they're trying to look like aliens, basically. it's not reality. You know, so in that respect, I think it's really bad news.
Back to the nature part,
sure,
of it. What locations? What were your favorite place that you took a picture of the natural ones?
most, well, I mean, a lot of them are taken in an aeroplane, you know, because I do a lot of traveling for different work, whether it's photography or music or charity. And I these days I can't sleep much in planes. I find it uncomfortable. I don't know what. I've seen every movie. Even as a kid, I've always loved looking out the window. And I just think it's very peaceful and very beautiful. And I try and capture that essence so that when you're looking at the photograph like that, for instance, that you do have that calmness about you.
I'm going to let you have a drink in a little bit, just a couple of more questions.
I'm all right.
Okay, well. Thank you so much for spending time with us. I loved every single one of them, and I wish you the best. Any future projects?
More of this. Well, apart from an album coming out next year, which is called Everything Changes, so I have to throw that in there. Thank you, though.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.